What's up, guys, and welcome back for the fifth episode of the N64 Chronicles. So, I tried and I waited as long as I could to shoot this to see if I could get my buddy in on it with me, and unfortunately, we couldn't get our schedules to sync up. So, I'm gonna have to go to this hockey game alone. But, we're gonna be playing Wayne Gretzky's 3D hockey. Now, again, and I've said this a few times already in this series, this is the game I got on my 8th birthday. This, with the combination of NHL 99, led to my love of hockey. Obviously, the EA series kind of does a little bit more of a realistic simulation of the hockey series, but this one is always going to stay close to my heart, and I'm going to show you guys why, because there's a really fun arcade mode in this game. So, I'm not going to waste any more time talking about it beforehand. We're just going to jump in, start slapping some pucks. So, let's go. Alright guys, so I'm going to show you a game from each mode. I'll explain really quick. There's arcade and simulation. And with simulation you can get the full 5-on-5. Medium. I am going to take my Sabres. Moment of silence for my Whalers that are no longer here. So we're going to take, like I said, my Sabres. We'll take Pekka.
Tonight's matchup, here's the opening faceoff.
So, with the simulation mode, you obviously get as close as they could as simulating a legit hockey game.
It's a blast! Deflected! Bombs away! Oh, spectacular! Boom! From behind! Chicago!
With, you know, as fast paced as this game is, it's a little silly doing the simulation just because, you know, this game is meant to be more arcadey. It essentially comes off as a hockey version of NBA Jam. Pretty much the key to scoring in this one is just using the one-timers. It's not the easiest to pull off, but if you can, it works. Like I said, I used to play this all the time as a kid, and I used to love the arcade mode. Pretty much as soon as I discovered the arcade mode, I never played simulation again. Until now, literally.
Robinson is Mary Matter up to it again. He shoots!
He loses the puck. Oh, a beautiful face.
That's another little trick I learned as a kid, to come in from the boards and just skate up into the crease. You can kind of trick the goalie's AI into thinking that you're going past him, but the trick with that one is getting past all your defenders in the first place. And of course the timing on releasing the shot. One thing I've always liked about this game, and I'll see if I can get it to display really quickly, is if you see he's got the puck, but I'm still controlling this guy back here, you can kind of use your team's AI to actually set up your own play, which is a really, really cool setup. It's something I don't even see really in games now. You know, because the way it's set up now, you know, you can lock yourself in the EA Sports series has a pro mode where you can lock yourself into a single position as a single player. So you can kind of do the same thing there, but it's not exactly the same. But what I like about this version of it is, you know, you can actually see who has the puck, where they are, and they pretty much don't give it up unless you tell them to. So you can either, you know, keep yourself set up with your own character and have them pass it back to you to kind of set up your own little one-timer situation, or, you know, you can control the shot from them too. Like I said, it's a really cool feature. And it's definitely not one you see more often nowadays. But to see it, you know, something that's 20 years old and actually work fairly well, it's pretty cool.
He turns it over. The man advantage has ended.
But see, like right there, if you notice that one, he technically was in control of the puck, but I made him shoot it.
Here's
off. He coughs it up. He shoots. Deflected. Stolen. He nails it. Another steal. It's a blast. What was he thinking?
You'll definitely notice, and it's one of the more kind of silly features of the game, the players are all extremely identical. You know, they're not going to be able to program in every single face, especially back then, but it kind of takes away from it a little bit. You know, there's not really any differences at all, not even like something as simple as like skin tone or anything like that. So it, you know, it's trying to promote the actual players, you know, with, as you saw on me entering into the game where I can select who, you know, my lock-in player is. So it kind of makes that a little redundant. Because, you know, you're selecting individual players, but then you can't really tell their individuality. Yeah, so it's not a horrible thing, but again, you know, trying to promote that and not really able to see it other than on menus. It's just, it's always been, you know, that one thing that's stuck out about this game to me is they're just clunky versions of each other.
Oh, a beautiful save. He shoots. He stops it.
I'm going to see if I can break this tie.
There's the seal. Oh, he trips him. It counts.
Nope, they did.
And here's the face-off. Here, hustle.
And I apologize if I sound like I'm kind of skipping over my words. I'm trying to focus on what I'm doing in the game, and doing that and talking isn't really the easiest thing.
Tremendous! Robin Hood and his merry men are up to it again. face-off. He turns it over. He shoots. Oh, spectacular. Here's the draw. From behind, he loses the puck. Buffalo goes on the power play. Here's the draw. It's a blast. Deflects it. 20 seconds left. He coughs it up.
Well, unless I can really storm back in third, I don't think this one's happening. Another thing you'll notice about this one is the incredibly high scores. The huge part of this game is more the arcade mode, which I'll be showing off next. This thing's not meant to be a full hockey simulator. They tried to do it with this mode, and you know, it works as far as getting the whole 5-on-5 in there, all the penalties, all that kind of stuff, but it doesn't really fully hold up as a hockey simulator, but it never really tries to. So it's kind of, you can't really fault them for it, because it's not like, you know, the main push of the game, like the EA's NHL series. I mean, this thing's made by Midway, who, you know, Mortal Kombat. So right away, you know you're not getting a legit hockey simulator, but for at the time, for full 3D and everything, you know, it worked. And it still does, you know, this is still a really fun game to play today. It's not gonna stand out because of how great the newer hockey games are. But this thing is still a blast to throw in every once in a while. Like, I'm getting my ass kicked right now, and I'm still having so much fun playing this thing. Of this loss.
Here's the draw. Looking to score. The shot. No good. He shoots. Oh, a beautiful save. It's a blast. Oh, spectacular. Bomb incredible.
Jesus.
And here's the face-off.
Oh, it's coming back. What the fuck, guy?
Here's the draw.
Well, I am just going to speed up the rest of this game for you guys, because I don't even want to suffer through the rest of this loss. So I will see you on the other side of this for the arcade mode. A slightly embarrassing score.
The NHL and the NHLPA.
But right now, we're going to jump over, switch up the settings for arcade mode. Ah, that might have been my issue too. I forgot you can manually change the ring size. So there's two ring sizes in here, and the arcade one's a little smaller and dumbed down. So, well, let's go opposites. We did the simulation on the arcade rink, so we're going to do arcade mode on the regular rink. I'm just going to keep the periods to a minute and a half. No penalties allowed in arcade mode, which makes it a lot more fun. I'm going to do the line changes on auto. Alright. Let's get this one set up. That's another cool thing too, is you can actually change the goalie, if you can tell up on the top left. I apologize for the flare up, it's that little white stripe coming in on the top left, right up there.
Tonight's matchup, Buffalo versus Chicago, here's the opening faceoff.
Alright, so you're gonna notice that the arcade mode is a lot more fast paced. Probably going to be just as high scoring, if not more. And yes, I am serious with the shortened period. But me playing on the actual sized rink might change that a little bit too. So you can already tell, huge rink in comparison. But the, trying to pull one off, can't get the line. That's the fun part of arcade mode, is you just get to lay each other out. No worry about penalties. You can even pull off, you know, the nets on fire, kind of like NBA Jam. I miss that one horribly. So this is where the real portion of the game shines through. It's probably going to be a little bit more low-scoring with me playing this on the regulation rink, so I might actually throw in another arcade game on the arcade rink. But this mode is the greatest thing ever. seen anything else like it on the PS3, along with NHL 11, I think it was. They released a 3-on-3 arcade hockey game with, at the time, current rosters. And it was, you know, the exact same thing, except you can actually get power-ups, too. I can't remember if there's a power-up mode in this one. Don't think there was. Well, then. Talk about a buzzer beater. Yeah, no, this mode is so much fun. Trying to trigger a fight for you guys too. That's not happening there. One victory in this video, in this episode. I love this because of how kind of ridiculous these guys look. Again, you know, it's the clunky 3D models that they used, but it's just hysterical. Apparently, I was reading up on it that because of this being produced by Midway, apparently there was some rumor started at the time that you could pull off pretty much Mortal Kombat fatalities in that little fight scene. And it's a completely bullshit rumor, but it just kind of makes me wonder, you know, what kind of stuff you'd be able to do as a hockey player with the fatalities. Like, that would have been a really cool hidden feature. Get the goddamn puck. Oh, I would have had the one timer. Alright, so I don't think I'm pulling off the 4-second miracle shot. We're gonna try from the face off. Damn. So it wasn't as embarrassing of a score. So I'm going to throw in a third game. Mostly for you guys to see the arcade mode on the arcade rink, but also for me to hopefully pull off one victory in this episode. I'm gonna actually switch it up this time. And not that I'm gonna know anybody on the team most likely, other than Shanahan, but I'm gonna take my old Whalers. So, we're gonna take Shanahan because it's the only name that jumps off at me.
Hartford versus Montreal. Here's the opening faceoff.
Alright, let's go Whalers.
Oh, he took a shot! Here's the draw. Sizzling! He steals it! Looking to score, he deflects it! Another steal!
I might be a little bit relentless in this one. But you can see, if you do the arcade mode on the arcade rink, all the action's kind of packed into itself. You know, there's really nowhere to go other than into the boards or into another player. Couple of different shots you can pull off. I've never been good at actually pulling it off.
What a setup! Oh, spectacular! 20 seconds left, he turns it over.
Jesus. Come on, I want to win one game.
Here's the draw. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
shit, we're going away.
4, 3, 2, 1. And that's all for the first period. The Canadian 3, the Whaler 2.
You know, this power shot you can pull off. I think if you get back-to-back goals with the same player, it does the whole net on fire kind of. Again, like NBA Jam. So it's a fun little mode, and I like the little ambulance siren that always goes off on the hard hits. And you know, especially in this mode, you know, there's no real deficit that can't be recovered. And that's gonna... Well, as far as that wasn't a goal.
He pops it up. He deflects it.
Is there a replay mode? I have to see that. That's a little upsetting. I don't know the controls for the replay mode. Okay, whatever. But pretty much it looked like he scored that from center ice. Come on! It's
This is, I mean, it's always constantly back and forth with the scoring in this one.
Here's the draw. Five kids hungry out there. It's a flag and play. Oh, what goaltending. I come back. No good. What sensational.
I can be a dick, too.
And here's the face-off.
I swear to God, if they had scored that, I would have been so pissed.
The Whaler, five.
Alright, last period. Let's see what we can do. Off to a good start, 5 seconds in. Just seemed to kind of like hover there for him.
He leveled them. Oh, a beautiful thing.
Yep, you can check your own players too. Going down with that fight, boys.
A fight is broken
out. I'll take it. 2 fight wins. At least I want something when we got the end of the episode. What the hell? I shot that.
Oh, he took a shot. The puck is on fire. Oh, he trips him. Bombed away. He drops it. Boom. Here's the
what? I had that.
And here's the face-off. The shot. The shot is blocked.
Come on.
Robin Hood and Terry Manor do it again. It's a blast and another save. 10, 9, 8, 6, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. The running deflected. 1.
Why didn't you shoot? Alright. Well, I lost all 3 games.
The Whaler.
That's kind of upsetting. Still had a lot of fun though. So let's sit and chat about this one for a moment. Alright, so we have our first sports title for the Nintendo 64, and personal favorite sport for me. Again, it's not a true hockey simulator, it doesn't try to be. I mean, it does throw in the simulation mode, but it's more just giving you the larger sized rink and the full team on team. The whole pull with this thing is the arcade mode, and it's so much fun. You know, like I said, I got this on my 8th birthday. I played it nonstop as a kid. I've completely forgotten about this thing until I dug out my N64 a few years back at my dad's house. And I completely forgot about how high scoring it was, how fast paced it was. And I was sitting there, and at the end of the second period, I was playing, it was like 11-10. So again, it's not your true hockey simulator, so if that's what you're looking for, this thing's not going to be that great, but as an N64 game, as an N64 hockey game, this thing is incredible. I've always enjoyed having this in my collection. This is probably one of the 5 N64 games I never even considered trading in. This thing is dirt cheap to go pick up, and I would never even pass this thing up for a heartbeat. But, you know, this isn't just reviewing the game. This is going through the N64 games, and this is a great one. You know, like I said, you know, not to keep repeating myself, but if you're looking for an actual hockey simulator, it's not the greatest out there, but, you know, if you're going for more arcade-y style, which this thing being made by the guys that did Mortal Kombat, it's exactly what you get with this one. And I could say it a million times, this thing is so much fun. So, speaking of Mortal Kombat, although it's not actually Mortal Kombat, it's just another side-screen fighter, next week's episode is going to be Killer Instinct Gold. One I've never played before. I know it's a huge fighting game on the Super Nintendo. So this is going to be cool to finally check out. I've heard good things about it. But more importantly, the week after that is your guys' vote. Star Wars Shadows of the Empire and Cruisin' USA, they share a release date. It came out on the exact same day. And I want to try to leave it up to you guys to vote on which one you'd rather see played first. They're both going to get played. It's just a matter of which one comes episode 7, the other one's going to be episode 8. So, you let me know either in the comments down below, over on Facebook, Instagram, wherever you want. Drop one of these names, and whatever's got the more votes, I'll be playing it on episode 7. This vote's also going to be another one to claim an Honest Gamer I Voted sticker, so if that's something that you want, let me know, and we'll figure out how to get it to you. Again, I can only ship those in the U.S. as of right now, but hoping one of these days I can start offering that for out of the country. So, that is going to wrap it up for the 5th episode. Hope you guys enjoyed watching me play some hockey. If you guys have this thing in your collection, don't ever let it go, and if you don't have it in your collection, it's got to be only $3 or $4. Go get it. You'll enjoy this. So, I'll see you guys next week with Killer Instinct Gold. Game on, have a good one.